Morning. Wow, I like your petrol station, man. Good morning, internet. It is 7:45 in the morning and welcome back to the channel. Welcome here in Crooked Tree in Belize. I am staying right here at the lagoon. It's a lot of bird life around here. There's a whole colony of, I don't know, some kind of white birds over there. Not entirely sure what they are. And Alaska is packed and ready to rock and roll. On another day, trying to reach the Lamanai ruins. So yeah, in the last video I failed miserably to reach them, and today is going to be attempt number two. So I'm staying now right here in Crooked Tree, and yesterday I tried to reach Lamanai from the south side, which failed. So now today I have to ride, well, first I have to ride quite far north, almost something until Orange Walk, and then I can take this road and then ride to Lamanai. So I have to make a massive detour and then come back the same way out. So because I have to make this long detour, I decided not to do it as a day trip and come back all the way down here. So that's why I'm bringing all my stuff. I'll go to Lamanai and then continue north towards the border with Mexico. I will not have time to cross the border today, I think. I'm going to try to stay the night in kind of the last town before the border called Corozal, right here at the coast. So that should keep me entertained for a day. I'm going to pack the last things and then I'm going to try to find a breakfast somewhere in town, because I don't think they do breakfast here. And I need fuel. That's another thing. I need fuel. Bye! Thank you! Off I go! Yeah, I'm first going to see if that petrol station is open, because there's supposed to be a small petrol station in town here. But I don't know if they're open already. I'm gonna check it out, because if not, it depends a bit. I might have to backtrack a little bit. Because otherwise the next petrol station is 50 kilometers from here. And I might make that. Or I might not. Here. It says here on the map. Ah. Hi! Morning. Wow, I like your petrol station, man. Nice. It's just normal, regular, right?
Yeah, normal, yeah. Regular.
Perfect. Yeah, full, please.
4 gallons?
Yeah.
14 gallon Belize.
Sorry?
14 gallon Belize.
Okay. Yeah, that's fine. Yeah.
Have to reset it after every gallon, right?
Oh, after every gallon, it's yeah, so okay.
That's the first one.
Yeah.
Second.
Yeah. Oh, stop. Okay, that's full.
Are you staying at Bird's Eye?
Sorry?
Are you staying at the Bird's Eye Lodge?
No, I was staying at the Yakana.
Oh, okay. I was wondering if was them that who told you, or did you find it on Google Map or?
Google Maps. I found it, yeah.
Yeah. That's it. That was changed.
Thanks, man.
Thank you.
Hey, do you know a place that where I can have a breakfast? Is it open now on Sunday morning?
Breakfast places in Crooked Tree is mainly lunch.
Ah.
Yeah.
Only in the lodge.
Yeah, only lodge would serve breakfast.
Yeah.
Other than that, it would only be lunch.
Okay. All right. Thank you. Okay. Thanks, man.
Yeah. But if you really want to have lunch, my uncle just came from a state there, back there in the blue house. I could ask there what he and his wife to make something for you, if that's okay with you.
For breakfast?
Yeah.
Now?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Where do I need to go?
Let me give them a call.
Sure. Thanks, man.
First time cookie tree?
Huh?
First time in country?
Yeah.
Hanky? But I have somebody here, so well, I want to drink Lee breakfast, but no way I could retreat and have Lee breakfast. I don't know if Jane would help out her.
Breakfast?
Yeah, well.
Lemon.
It's okay.
Okay.
Okay. She'll come back to power cycle. Or lady come back to power cycle.
Yeah.
Alright. he'll live right in the blue house.
So I continue on the road here?
Mm-hmm.
The first blue house?
Yeah, first blue house on the right-hand
on
side.
On the right-hand side. Right. Cool, thanks, man.
Okay, sure.
I'll go there now. Morning. That's what I like about these small towns, you know? People really help each other out. And blue house. This blue house. I think I'm just now going to just his family or random people. Hello? Good morning! Very far.
Oh man.
From the Netherlands, Holland.
On second?
Yeah.
Wow!
3 years.
2 years.
More than 100,000 kilometers.
Damn!
That's a lot of trouble.
Yeah.
Alright. Bye guys! Bye, thanks! That was the nicest thing. So he took me to his uncle, Hank. And they made the breakfast for me. I got a coffee and homemade cinnamon bread made by his wife. And they've also gave me a big chunk of the bread to go on the road. Really, really nice. So that is a rather good start of the day. I'm sure today I will succeed in reaching Lamanai. Welcome to Guinea Grass Village. I just realized that I am riding through a Mennonite community again. No electricity poles and horses and horse carts everywhere. Oh yeah, there's the horse carts. Also see the windmills. So. Here, welcome to Indian Church Village. Ah, here it is. What a nice little entrance. Quite a big area. So I finally made it to Lamanai. Lamanai means submerged crocodile in Maya language. So this site dates from the early pre-classic Maya period, and it has been continuously occupied for thousands of years. You can see it's also hidden in the jungle. And now I am walking to a temple which is called, I think it's the Temple of Masks. I have arrived at the Mask Temple. Wow. Oh, this is amazing. I mean, once you've seen some Mayan temples or pyramids, you know, you can say, oh, you've seen them all. Because of course the style is very similar in all these sites. But this, I have not seen before. Look at this. These masks are over 4 meters tall. It's incredible, right? So this temple has undergone construction in kind of different phases. So it hasn't always looked like this. And they first started building this temple 100 years BC. And at the time, the top part wasn't there yet. Also, this whole front part wasn't there yet. And kind of on the second level over there, there were some masks similar to what you see here. Later, they were closed off again, and these were built. So this part of the temple was built in 450 to 500 years AD. And in a later stage, they put stones in front of it again to cover it up. And then later, they uncovered it again. So what I've understood is that kind of that's what happened with different rulers, different architects, and they kept on coming back to the place and kind of give it their own signature. But the structure itself, like, you cannot enter it anywhere, so it's a solid structure, except for the front bit. At the time, that used to be a place where you could enter, but most of that has calmed down. But it's the only Mayan temple where I've ever seen like sculptures like this and like these faces. And what you see here on the side, that was inspired on snakes, so you can also see a little bit like a snake symbol there. And behind the face, they found a tomb, and they think it was a very important person that was buried there, because they found remains of hummingbirds. And hummingbirds in Mayan culture, they're a symbol of love. So the person that was buried here must have been well loved by the community. But who it was exactly, I believe that is still unknown. What an awesome place, right? And yeah, it's just kind of in the middle of the jungle. And so this place as well, the same as Nakum and Yakshcha, all of these sites were abandoned when the Mayan civilization collapsed. And yeah, as I said before, nobody really knows why they collapsed. There are several theories. One is that there was a drought, or that they just became too big. They kind of, yeah, were a victim of their own success, and there were too many people and not enough resources, which created chaos and ultimately led to the end of the Mayan civilization. But of course, I'm not sure what really was the case. So this is the highest structure of the site, and I'm not allowed to climb on it, you can see. But wow, this is a proper high temple, and it looks like there also used to be some sculptures or faces on that side. And you can see something over here as well. But that's all quite weathered away, unfortunately. Incredible. I mean, how many years must it have cost to build something like this? Unbelievable. I have located another pyramid. This one is called the Jaguar Temple. It's also a pretty tall one, look at that. And well, this actually resembles a jaguar. Do you see it? So the eyes over there and there, and then the nose. I'm guessing that's the representation of the jaguar. Let's go back to Alaska, because I had to leave Alaska at a unguarded parking with all my things on there. That's actually, I was already thinking that might happen. That's why I wanted to ride here without any luggage. But obviously, it didn't work out. As you can see in the last video. So now I had to bring all my stuff. Let's get going again. That was nice. That was nice. I did enjoy that. And yeah, it was definitely worth making the detour. But now I'm going to head towards, oh, really towards Mexico now. So that in the next video, I will cross the border into Mexico. How about that? I'm taking a different route out now. I think it'd be interesting. Otherwise, I'm riding the exact same way back. It's quite nice. I hope it will stay dry though. Look at that. The rainy season is coming, finally. I have arrived in Corozal. Wow. Look at the color of the water here. Amazing, right? So this, yeah, this is gonna be my last glimpse of the Caribbean side, because in Mexico I'm not planning to go towards the Yucatan, which is, well, kind of that way, but I'm gonna go straight inland. So let me find a place to stay for tonight. Sunshine View Hotel. It sounds amazing. Is it open? Right, I have a place to stay, which is just over there, but I can ride the bike around, which is nice. Look at that! Right here at the beach, how about that? Yeah, I'll take this one. Through the garden. Bumpy dumpy dum. And this is my little house. So I'll park just here. That's very nice, very cute. Bathroom. I love it, I love it. This is that chunk of cinnamon bread that I got this morning from that nice family. And just the smell of the cinnamon alone, it is so yum. It is super dense and sweet. So yeah, this is like a quarter of the bread. They were massive. So nice. It doesn't require anything else, just this. Super delicious. So it appears that I am the only person staying here. There's nobody. So I don't know where the people are at. I mean, you can definitely tell that tourism in Belize is not yet back at kind of pre-pandemic levels. It's pretty quiet in most places. So I'm going to end this video now. That was it for today. And in the next video, crossing the border into Mexico. So I am kind of recharging my batteries for that, because border crossings are always a little bit hectic and energy draining. So, but I'm also really looking forward to Mexico, really looking forward to it. I think it's also this time I didn't really stay long in Belize because I've traveled here before quite extensively. So this time I was kind of feeling like I don't really want to go to the exact same places I went last time. So I went a little bit faster, but Mexico, I've been to parts of Mexico, but there's still a lot of Mexico that I've never been. So that I am really excited about. So yeah, you'll see that in the next video. If you like this one, I hope it, please give me a big thumbs up, subscribe down below, and then I'll see you in the next video.